Hello, this is Leslie Waters, and this is for all the catering and hospitality students at Farnborough College. I hope you're all well and keeping safe in the lockdown. So I thought I would talk to you today a little bit about scallops and a fabulous dish which I first had when I was in Paris many years ago. And let's have a look at the scallops. At the moment I can only get them without the coral or the roe which is attached to them. You can see that they're not that sort of bright white colour, which means that they are fresh, they haven't been frozen. And sometimes they have a little bit of a muscle attached to them, which you want to remove. Not that it's poisonous, but it goes a little bit on the tough side. And I don't know whether or not you can see it there. It's quite white. You just need to use your fingers or a little knife, and then you can just literally, very, very gently pull it away, okay? As I said before, it won't hurt you. It just goes a little bit on the tough side. So cooking them. Okay, so start off cooking them using a little bit of rapeseed oil. I like using rapeseed oil rather than olive oil because it can come up to a higher temperature. If the pan is very, very hot, then just take it off the heat slightly. You can see that I'm using a fabulous non-stick pan here, and I'm just going to put them in, but just before I put them in, I'm going to season, literally just before they go into the pan, with a little bit of salt and black pepper. They're deliciously sweet, and what I'm going to do now is put this back on the heat, and I'm going to put them in. And that's the noise that you want to hear, that sort of gentle sizzling, not a hazing of the pan. They're gentle little fellows, scallops, and as much as you want to cook them fairly fast, you don't want them going too fast, otherwise you ruin the flavour. So you can see that they're sizzling away quite nicely, and I love butter on my scallops, but I'm not going to put the butter in now because it would burn. Okay, touch more salt going in, and I'm just going to leave them alone, just so that they get a bit of a crust. Okay, so let's talk about the next part of the recipe, which is the fruit that they're going to sit on, which I've just toasted very gently, and I'm just going to rub the garlic over the fruit. I think one of the loveliest flavors with scallops is garlic and butter, and maybe just a squeeze of lemon. But today we're going to use a touch of balsamic. So rub that over the top. Take your serving dish, which I'm going to put here, and put your warm fruit on there. Let's go back to the scallops now. They probably take a minute and a half, 2 minutes, depending on how big they are, each side. Bit more pepper. And you can almost see them when they're starting to pop out of the pan. And that, they almost pop, slightly come off. And you want to get them that lovely, gentle, almost biscuit colour. Turn them over. Really, you don't want to overcook them. You can grill your scallops, tempura them. You can even ceviche them by putting them in lime and letting the lime cook them. You can see that they're a lovely colour there. And that's really what you want. The pan is quite hot now. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get rid of the heat from underneath, and I'm just gonna let them stay like that in the residual heat of the pan. Okay. So the salad that we've got here is just some nice leaves. Big tip when you're dressing a salad is always to put the dressing on the bottom first of your dish. And I'm just going to use a tiny little splash of balsamic, not too much, and a few sun-dried tomatoes, which I just chopped. And I'm just going to toss those together like that. This dish, as I said before, I first had in Paris, and it does go really well. You can do the same with griddled goat's cheese.
right? But today we're going to do it with scallops. So I'm going to pick this up now, and I'm just going to literally pop it on top of my fruit. Like so. Back to the scallops in the residual heat. They're lovely. I'm going to finish them off now with the butter. So hopefully, because I've let the pan cool down a bit, the butter is not going to burn. I'm using unsalted butter because unsalted butter has a less chance of burning. And you can see the butter is beautifully coating those scallops now. And it's not burning. Just take that over like so. And then just take your scallops and put them on top of your leaves. Probably for a starter, 3 or 4 scallops will be plenty. Okay. All right, so I'm going to lift these out now into this dish, and then in the butter that's in here, I'm just going to put a few, and this is really unusual, a few pui lentils. And a splash of balsamic. And a little bit of oil. Extra virgin olive oil. What you don't want to do is get the pan. You can see there's steam coming off that pan. You don't want to get that olive oil too hot. And then just take your lovely pre-lentil dressing and just trickle that over your scallops like that. So simple, but so delicious. There you go. The students, the catering students from Farnborough College, stay safe, stay well.